Good afternoon, everybody. I wish to thank the AIOS Scientific Committee and Dr. Krishna Prasad and everybody in the refractive course, who have given me an opportunity to share my experience and outcomes of refractive surgery with a double frequency laser. There are no financial disclosures or conflict of interest. Now, among the plethora of so many lasers around, why I chose Zeiss? As it is more than 170-year-old company, it's a world leader in optics, manufactures microscopes, fundus cameras, lenses, lasers, LASIKs, and even semiconductors, which I didn't know that. One of the oldest existing optics manufacturers in the world, has worldwide presence. We have an association in our hospital and trust on Zeiss since more than past 25 years. Stands for impeccable quality, value, and things which are built to last. My wish list for a refractive platform were cutting-edge technology, which should be clinically relevant, the best optics in business, easy to use, intuitive interface, less recurring cost, sturdy, and have excellent service backup. So there was a plethora of machines which were available in the market. And I am happy that, you know, when you compare these on all the parameters, the Zeiss MEL 90 matches them and even outshines most of them in all the parameters like fast eye tracker, Gaussian beam profile, flying spot, giving you an option of topo guided treatment, press biopic correction, and a femtosecond link. So the clinically relevant features, which I really admire, one of the unique selling propositions for this machine for me has been, for the MEL 90, has been FlexSequence, which is my ability to choose 250 Hertz or 500 Hertz laser for the kind of procedures which I want to do. It has an advanced ablation algorithm, an ultra fast ablation speed of 1.3 seconds per diopter, a patented adaptive plume removal system, topo guided LASIK and press bion capability, fast and hassle free gas exchange, no nitrogen generators, no other cylinders. And in my past 5 years experience, I have not had a single breakdown in which I had to call in Zeiss and stop my procedures. My preferred range of correction is 8 to 9 diopters myopia, 5 diopters hyperopia, and up to 5 diopters of astigmatism. The unique feature of FlexSequence gives me a very fast laser for performing standard LASIK, and also gives me 250 Hertz laser for making a gentle treatment on the surface. That is, when I do PRK, I switch to 250 Hertz. That has been postulated to cause less heating of the surface compared to 500 Hertz. And the less the heating, the less the haze, and the better results and prediction in your overall accuracy. Advanced ablation algorithm stands for a combination of tissue-saving algorithm and an aspherical optimized algorithm, which is one profile which fits all and gives you the complete treatment range. We all know that cyclotorsion can affect our outcomes. For astigmatism greater than 2 diopters, even a 5 to 6 degree rotation of the patient's head or cyclotorsion of the eye can give you around a surprise or under and over correction of 0.5 diopters of astigmatism. So there are two ways of correcting cyclotorsion in MEL 90. One is the automated system with the Z-Align, or a manual marking with the bevel marker, which I do like we do for our toric IOLs. You mark it manually. And this is just a schematic to show you, this is the eye. And these are the marks which were horizontal when the patient was sitting down. I marked it with a bevel marker. When the patient lies down, there is some amount of cyclotorsion. So with this particular machine, in the software, you have a tab called a zero line. When you press that before you treat, it shows you a horizontal red line onto the corneal surface. And then you can manually rotate the patient's head to align these marks, which you had made with the bubble marker with the zero line. When you do that, and when you subsequently treat, the results are really gratifying. I have found very little under or over correction in astigmatism with that, extremely accurate. And it is already published that manual limbal markings and iris resistance software are equally effective and safe in LASIK. Our experience and results with the MEL 90 have been, we have treated 850 eyes. This is partial records from our center. 51% were males, mean age was 22 years. A staggering 98.5% of the patients were satisfied with LASIK and 96% with PRK. We did around 41% PRK procedures and 59% SBK LASIK. As I started, this percentage was around 80% LASIK and 20% PRK, but over the 4 to 5 years, I have switched more and more to PRK. So PRK is my go-to procedure now. And slowly I'm developing more and more confidence as I find it to be extremely good in terms of results, safety, and predictability. My correction raise has been from 0.5 to 11 diopters and plus 0.5 to plus 5 diopters hyperopia and 0.25 diopter cylinder to 5 diopter cylinders. Our experience, final uncorrected visual acuities, 96% of the total patients achieved UCV of 6x6, 99% in LASIK patients were 6x6, and 92% in PRK patients. This compares very favorably with the data which Dr. Praveen had also mentioned, the LVPI data, 93% patients who were uncorrected visual acuity of 6x6. Our experience with the Moria SBK one use plus microkeratome has also been very, very rewarding. From day one, I have only done SBK LASIK, 100 micron flaps, which compare to your femto flaps. Have made flaps without complications ranging from 40 to 47K. It has a disposable head with blade, which eliminates risk and cost of re-sterilization. Very good flap edges, no DLK, no epithelial ingrowths. Visually insignificant microstri are definitely observed because the flaps are thin. Flap-related complications have been very low, to just 1%. My take-home message is invest wisely, especially in post-COVID scenario. PRK has a bright future in my refractive case preferences, and I think soon it'll only be PRK and SMILE, which will be there, flaps will go, because you have these both extremes to tackle and you have very good predictability in both. ZEISS has the most comprehensive and upgradable refractive platforms as of today. You will have to price your refractive procedures in these times attractively. Excellent results and commitment to quality alone triumphs. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Chikitan Singh.